Hello, welcome to this channel Gain Java Knowledge. And today in this video we will discuss about map, reduce and filter methods. As we know, map, reduce and filters are intermediate operations to transforming and filtering the elements, and a terminal operation to gather the data again. And there are also more intermediate operations. But with these three intermediate methods like map, filter and reduce, we can do a lot, so it's worth knowing them intimately. And in this video I will show you how to create streams and then transform them using three widely used higher order method named map, filter and reduce. In our previous video, we have already discussed about stream and how to create sequential or parallel stream. So, once you have a stream object, you can perform any methods on that stream like map, reduce or filter. So, okay, let's start with first method, that is map. In simple words, the map method is used to transform one object into another by applying a function. And map method takes a lambda expression as its argument and uses it to change every individual element present in the stream. Okay, let's create one simple Java program and we'll use the map to convert all the elements of an array of strings to uppercase. So here I have just created one simple Java class, and inside this class I will just create a string of array, that is name arrays, and here I will just create new string array, and this array of string will contains multiple names like abc, Karan, Mohit, Vivek, so now I will convert these names into uppercase by using map method. So what I will do here, first we need to create stream from this array. So here I will call name.arrays as stream function. So here I will call arrays class dot stream function arrays dot stream, and inside this we need to pass a name of arrays as a parameter. So after converting the name of arrays into stream, now I will call map method. So this map will be used to convert name into uppercase. All name will be converted into uppercase, name dot to uppercase. So after converting these all names into uppercase, it will create a stream of string. So now we need to convert this stream of string into array again. So here I will call toArray function, and inside this I will just pass string array of new. So here I will use method reference. So now it will convert again into array. So now here I will assign the statement. So these are the new array. So here I will print this array, and we will see every name will be in the uppercase. Arrays dot to string, and here I will just pass new array. So now I will run this application. So here we can see in the output every name in uppercase letter: ABC, Karan, Mohit and Vivek. So here first we have converted our arrays to stream, then we have applied map method on this stream, and after applying map method it will return the stream of string. Then we need then we again need to convert into array. So we are calling here two array function. These are also called terminal function that we are using in end. So like this we can use the map method. Now next we will discuss about filters. So here we can see it's iterating each function, like it's making uppercase letter to each name. So if we want to make uppercase letter only for few names, like if the length of the name is greater than 3, that only name we need to convert into uppercase, then we can use filters. So here we will discuss about filters. As we saw in the map method, it processes every single element in a stream object. You might not always want to process each element. So sometimes you might want to work with only a subset of elements. So to do so, you can use a filter methods. And just like a map method, the filter method expects a lambda expression as its argument. Okay, let's create one Java program and see how to use filter. So here we will use filter example. So if you have an array of strings and you want to create a subject of it which contains only those names whose length is more than 3 characters, then we can use filter. So here what I will do, here first I will convert string of arrays into stream, arrays dot stream, and here we need to pass name of arrays. So now this name of arrays will be converted into stream, and here I will call filter method, and this filter method will expect argument as a lambda expression like the map method. So here I will copy it name, and here I will put the condition name dot length is greater than 3, and now I will call map method to convert that names into uppercase. So here it will convert only those names whose length is greater than 3 into uppercase. To uppercase. Now I will again call toArray function. So this will convert stream of array into simple string of array. String of array. So here I will use double colon operator and new function. So now here what I will do, I will just assign one element. Array, and here we can see first I have converted arrays into stream, then I have called filter method to filter the object, and I have added the condition to filtering the data, then again I have called the map method to convert the lowercase into lowercase character into uppercase, then I got the stream of string, then I have again called toArray method to convert the stream of string into array object. So here I will just print filter example. So now I will print it, run this application, and here we can see here I just need to call arrays dot toString method, then we can see the output properly. And here we just need to pass array, and here we can see, here we can see only those names whose length is greater than 3. So filter method is only used to perform filtering the objects. And the next one is reduce method, and the reduce method is also known as terminal operation because they are always present at the end of chain of stream of methods. We have already been using a reduction method in our previous example that we can see here. The टू एरे मेथड इट्स ए टर्मिनल ऑपरेशन बिकॉज इट कन्वर्ट्स ए स्ट्रीम ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट इन टू द एरे सो इट्स नोन एज टर्मिनल ऑपरेशन एंड इफ यू वॉन्ट टू परफॉर्म मोर कॉम्प्लेक्स रिडक्शन ऑपरेशन हाउ एवर यू मस्ट यूज द रिड्यूस मेथड अनलाइक द मैप एंड फिल्टर मेथड द रिड्यूस मेथड एक्सपेक्ट टू आर्ग्यूमेंट्स One is identity element that is empty string, and second one is lambda expression. So these are expecting two arguments. The identity elements you can say the initial value for a variable, and second is lambda expression which operation you want to perform. Okay, let's create one program and see how it will work. So here what I will do. Here I will just use reduce method example. So here I will call arrays.stream because we can apply these methods on stream. So first we need to convert name of arrays into stream. Now I will call reduce method. So here I will call this one. That is expecting one parameter as identity and second parameter as binary operator accumulator. That is lambda expression that we can use here. So here we need to pass identity. Identity means its initial value. So here I am just assigning empty value. And here what I will do. Here I will just adding the names. Name one. Comma name 2 and here I will just use lambda expression sign and name 1 plus name 2 just adding these names so here I will use space so how here I will assign the variable So its name combination of all names and now I will just print this string reduce example plus combination now I will just run this application and here we can see this is a combination of all characters Now here you can see all names are combined into a single string. Here we can apply reduce function on integer also. Like this we have a number of array and if we want to get the sum of these numbers then we can call number of array to first we need to convert number of arrays into stream then only we can apply reduce method so here I will pass number of array and here I just need to call reduce function so inside reduce I will just pass the identity means what's the initial value for variable here I am assigning just 0 and here we need to assign lambda expression so here a and b the name of elements and here a plus b So now here I will just assign the variable sum So now I will just print the sum of all elements So what will be the output 1 plus 2 3 3 plus 3 6 6 plus 4 10 and the output will be 15 So now I will just run and check the output So here we can see on the console the sum is 15 and if we don't want to use lambda expression then we can also use the method reference and if we want to use method reference then we can call like this arrays.stream.reduce and inside reduce we just need to pass integer double colon sub and it will return the optional object. So we need to call the get function to get the actual object. So here I will just assign the variable name sum using method reference. So now I will just run this application again, and here we can see the output is same, that is 15. Now I will show you one more example that will be the combination of all map, filter, map and reduce method. We will apply these three methods on single stream. So here first I will get the list of student, get student list. So this student list contains four students. So here we can see the value of this object. This student contains four objects, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, and there is two subjects Java and one is C, and one is C++ student. Two students for Java and one for C and one for C++. Now here we just need to print the students which have Java language. So what I will do here, I will get the list of student. This list contains four student. So first I will apply the filter and will get the student, only those student who have Java subject. So first we need to convert into stream. Now we'll apply filter, and here I will add the condition student.getSubject.equal, ignore case, here we need to call, and we just need to get the students who have Java subject. And after getting the students who have Java subject, we need to get the total sum of the numbers. So here I will use map method, and here I will call s dot get marks. First I have filtered the students and getting only those students who have Java subject. After that I have used map method to get the marks from student object. I am only getting marks. So after that I will call reduce function. So I will add the marks of students who have Java subject. So here I will call reduce function, and inside reduce I will just use method reference integer colon colon sum. So I will just doing the sum of marks, and here we need to call get method, then it will return actual value, otherwise it will return optional object, optional of integer. So sum of Java marks. So here we can check the Java marks. One student have 80 and second student have 60. So the output will be here 140. When I will print the value, the output will be 140. So here we can see the output, the sum of Java marks is 140. Like this we can perform multiple operations on streams. Here we have just performed three operations, that is map, filter and reduce. Okay, thanks for watching this video.